This video is created by Jagrat Creations, wherein I want to solve one sum on accounting for business purchase. Here company is purchasing the business of a sole proprietor. Observe the sum that I intend to solve here before you. This is the sum that I want to solve here before you. Aman Limited was incorporated by taking over the business of a from 1st of April 2017. The following is the balance sheet as on 31st of March 2017. Company takes over the business with a fixed assets and loan on the following terms. Fixed assets should be depreciated at 10%. Value of goodwill estimated 80,000. Company realized 80,000 from the sundry debtors as an agent of vendor in full settlement discharge all trade creditors by paying 68,000 for a commission of 3% on amount collected and 2% of the amount paid. Creditors accepted 10% preferential shares of rupees 100 each in discharge of the loan. After realization of the debts and discharge of the liability, the total amount due to the vendor was settled by payment of rupees 5,440 in cash and the balance in the shape of fully paid up equity share of rupees 10 each. Show purchase consideration, past journal entries in the books of company, also give the balance sheet of a company after taking over the business of a. Here I am going to prepare balance sheet in the form of Schedule 3. Now see, business of a sole proprietor is purchased by company. Company has purchased all assets and liabilities except debtors and creditors. For debtors, company has committed to collect the debtors on behalf of a. Company has committed to pay the creditors on behalf of vendor. The commission is going to be charged for these services 3% of the amount collected from debtors and 2% of the amount paid to creditors. So all these assets and liabilities are purchased, but these debtors and creditors are not purchased. Now debtors, company has taken debtors of 84,000 for collection. Company could collect 80,000. 4,000 rupees could not be collected, so it's a bad debts. This bad debt is a loss. This is a loss of Mr. A. It is not a loss of company. If it is a company's loss, expenses and losses are debited by the company. But when this is a loss of Mr. A, his suspense account will be debited for that. Similarly, creditors are 71,200. Amount paid for creditors is 68,000. So 71,200 minus 68,000, 3,200 is a discount received. Discount received is an income or a gain. It is not a gain of company. If it is a gain of company, company can credit it. But it is a gain of Mr. A. So his suspense account will be credited for that. By this suspense means amount payable is not certain. But the amount the loss and gain are ascertained, the suspense gets over and the amount of suspense which has really become payable will be transferred to A's account. So long as the amount to be paid to A for this collection of debtors and payment of creditor is not certain, we will write the amount in the A's suspense account. This is an important point that I wanted to tell you. Now let me start with the sum. First of all, I'll prepare purchase consideration statement. Now what is purchased? Fixed assets should be depreciated at 10%. So land and building purchased less 10%. 1,44,000 is the purchase price of land and building. Same way plant and machinery purchased at 10% less. So 2,800 rupees are deducted. 25,200 is the purchase price. Furniture less 10%, 18,000 is the purchase price. Goodwill estimated at 80,000, so goodwill purchase for 80,000 and loan 120,000 is deducted therefrom. So this is the value of assets that has been purchased. From that liability will be deducted. We will find the net amount payable to A for purchase of these assets and liabilities. So this is the amount payable to A. Now I have committed to collect the debtors and pay the creditors. If loss occurs in collection from debtors, it is a loss of SOS suspense account, it is to be debited. While payment to creditors, if any discount is received, it's an income of A, so his suspense account is to be credited. When I take the debtors of A, the entry is vendor's debtors account debit to vendor's suspense account because the amount payable is not certain. When I take the creditors of Mr. A, vendor's suspense account debit to creditors, vendor creditors account credit because the amount to be deducted for payment of debtor is also not certain. Let me first prepare a working note for all these things. So debtors less bad debts, so cash received will be received, cash received will be found out. From that I am required to make payment to the creditors. When I go for payment to creditors, I earn discount, so discount received is to be deducted, so I will get the net amount paid to creditors. From this collection from debtors and payment of creditors, I am entitled to have a commission of 3% of the amount collected and 2% of the amount paid. So I'll deduct commission from the total amount payable. So net amount payable will be worked out. Now let me complete this working note. Debtors are 84,000. Creditors taken 71,200. Amount collected from debtors 80,000. Difference I am going to find out. Payment made to creditors 68,000. Difference will be identified as discount received. I am entitled to have 3% commission on the amount collected from debtors and 2% commission on the amount paid to creditors. Now let me work it out. Now 84,000 and 80,000 difference is 4,000, that is bad debts and discount. Here I get the missing item as discount received 3,200. So this is the net amount payable. I collected from debtors 80,000, I paid to creditors 68,000, 12,000 is payable, but from that I am entitled to have a deduction for discount. So 80,000 into 3%, that is a discount for collection from debtors, and this is a commission for payment to creditors. So this total commission is deducted, this is the amount payable to vendor Mr. A. So these are the two working notes that I have prepared, one for purchase of business and second for collection of debtors on behalf of vendor and payment to creditors on behalf of vendors. After preparing all these things, I want to write down the journal entry, but I am going to prepare two accounts. One account is account and cash and bank account, because I am required to prepare the balance sheet, so I prepare bank account. Business is purchased, so business purchase account debit to A's account credit, being purchase consideration payable. Amount payable to A is credited to A's account. Now what is purchased in business? Land and building is acquired, debit what comes in. So land and building account debit, plant and machinery account debit, furniture account debit, goodwill account debit, to loan account credit, to business purchase account credit. So this is assets and liabilities, which is a part of business purchase, acquired, is recorded by this entry. Now, after this entry, I want to write down the entry for this working note. I have committed to collect debtors. So, vendor debtors account debit to vendor suspense account. Why suspense account? Because the amount payable to vendor is not exact 84,000, subject to changes in light of bad debts and discount allowed. So, I use the word suspense account. Instead of writing the word vendor's account, I write the word suspense account because the amount payable is not certain. Similarly, vendor suspense account debit to vendor's creditors account credit. Here the amount to be recovered from vendor for payment to creditors is not certain because discount received is going to occur while making payment to creditors. So I have written the vendor suspense account to vendor's creditors account. Now cash received 80,000, cash or bank account debit 80,000 to vendor's debtors account. This is amount collected from debtors. Now the loss occurred at the time of collection of debtors that will be debited to vendor suspense account. The amount received is debited to bank account. Now what is the loss occurred? 4,000. That is to be debited to vendor suspense account debit to vendor debtors account credit. Instead of writing these two journal entries, if you want to write one journal entry, you can write one journal entry. Bank account debit, vendor suspense account debit to vendor debtors account credit. But I have recorded two separate entries. Now, payment to creditors is going to be recorded. So vendor's creditors account debit to bank account. So bank account is credited for the payment made to creditors. Gain of 3,200 It is a gain of vendor. Gain of Mr. A, not my gain. So it will be credited to vendor's suspense account. So vendor's creditor's account debit to vendor's suspense account credit being profit on payment to vendor's creditors. Now, commission entry. Commission is my income. Commission is the income of the company that will be credited to capital reserve while preparing the balance sheet. The amount to be collected from vendor suspense. So vendor suspense account debit to commission account credit. This commission account will be transferred to capital reserve account while preparing the balance sheet. Now, after recording these entries, I am required to find out the amount equity share capital given to A. Now, over and above, 8240, vendor suspense account debit to A's account. Now, the amount to be paid is certain, so A's account is credited for the amount net payable after deducting commission, etc., as per this working note. So, this is the amount payable to Mr. A. Now, creditors accepted 10% preference shares. And after doing all these things, the cash paid to A, 5,440 in cash and the balance in the shape of fully paid up equity shares. So A's account debit to cash account. So this is a payment made to A. Difference is paid by equity shares. So equity shares are given 1,55,440 minus 5,440. So these are the equity shares given. So A's account debit to equity share capital account credit to bank account credit. This is the entry for payment to A is recorded. Now, loan is settled by giving preference shares. So, loan account debit to preference share capital account credit. This is how all entries are recorded in the books of company. After recording all this entry, I want to prepare a balance sheet in the books of company. I would prefer to prepare the balance sheet as per Schedule 3. Just observe. For that, I am going to prepare notes on accounts from this information. So this is the closing bank balance, which is required for preparation of balance sheet. Here I prepare notes on accounts. These are the titles in which the information is collected as per Schedule 3. Reserves and surplus, non-current assets, fixed assets, tangible, intangible, current assets. In that I'm going to write down cash and cash equivalents. Now tangible fixed assets, land and building, plant and machinery, furniture, intangible assets, goodwill. Loan is converted into preference shares, so that will go to preference share capital. In the titles of shareholders fund, share capital, preference share capital. This is the equity share capital given for purchase of business. This is the bank balance, cash and cash equivalent. And this commission, as I told to you, will be identified as capital reserve in the balance sheet. Now this is the total capital. This is the capital reserve. Now in light of this, I am going to prepare the balance sheet as per Schedule 3. Equity liability. So this is the share capital. This is reserves and surplus. Non-current assets, fixed assets. This is cash and cash equivalents. The total of my balance sheet should agree. That works out to be 2,73,760. This is how the balance sheet gets prepared. Now this is a sum wherein I have tried to explain you journal entries, preparation of balance sheet. Even journal entries are also explained repeatedly. One, while reading the sum, and second, by solving the sum. I have tried to explain you all these things. All the journal entries, if you want to see at one place, you can find all the journal entries at one place. So this is how the sum gets solved. I feel that you have followed all these things. Thanks to you.